to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St. Patrick's. Welcome to our Holy Thursday service. We welcome all of you who are watching online, and for those of you who will be with us through Holy Week and into Easter, we're very grateful to have all of you, all of us, together this evening. Hello, Aileen.
Hello, Chris.
So we just want to tell you when our service starts tomorrow. Oh, we have a couple things happening tomorrow.
Absolutely. At 3 o'clock, our 7th and 8th graders are going to put on the living stations. They've worked very hard, and they've been studying our beautiful Stations of the Cross so that we can celebrate and remember all that Jesus did for us on Good Friday.
And tomorrow evening at 7 p.m., we will have our Good Friday service.
And Saturday at 7:30 is the Easter Vigil, and we would love to have as many, but anybody who wanted to come that.
Also, excuse me, Easter morning, we have an 8 a.m. Mass and a 10 a.m. Mass, which I understand is something special.
Absolutely. We've been having so much fun at Word for Kids with our younger kids. On Sunday morning at 10 o'clock, we will have a very special Word for Kids with a couple surprises.
Ooh, I love surprises, especially on Easter Sunday.
Absolutely.
Let's quiet our minds and open our hearts as we continue to journey through Holy Week. We invite you, as you're able, to please stand.
Let us sing together our opening hymn, number 242, Table of Plenty, number 242.
Provide for all that we need. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My friends, as we gather together to celebrate the sacred time of Triduum, today we recall the institution of the Eucharist and the priesthood and the washing of the feet. And as we gather together to celebrate this Eucharist at this time, we bring the oils that were blessed by our bishop on Tuesday.
Dear friends, we gather together on this holy night to begin. Church throughout the world, we commemorate the suffering and death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We begin as he did at the Passover table of the Last Supper. 2 days ago, Bishop Robert McManus, united with priests and bishops of the Church of Worcester, consecrated the Holy Chrism and blessed the oils for use in the anointing of the sick and the preparation of catechumens for baptism. Tonight, we receive these holy oils for the sacramental life of our parish community. By means of these powerful symbols, the crucified and risen Savior will continue in our midst the work he established at his death and resurrection: forgiveness, healing, and new life.
Let us now stand before our God as we seek his mercy and forgiveness.
Kyrie.
God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. May friends, let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. They may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup. After supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter and said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand it later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had finished washing their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that, as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Experts tell us that over 50% of all Americans report that they are or are regularly experiencing bouts of loneliness. It's actually listed as a major health risk for Americans of every age and gender and ethnicity. Now, the Bible has quite a lot to say about loneliness, and it starts in the very first chapters of Scripture, when we hear God say that it is not good for man to be alone. Interestingly enough, it was the first thing that God said was not good about the earth. Because you see, God knows that man is only fully complete when in relationship with other people. And so, of course, knowing that, I suppose one of the great spiritual questions that God invites us to ponder and to think about is, what kind of relationship do you seek to have with God? Now, the shocking thing about God is that of all the things that he is, the one thing that he wants more than anything else is to be our friend. God seeks to be in relationship with each and every one of his children. God seeks to be in friendship with all in the world. And knowing that, I suppose one of the questions that comes to my mind is, what is it in the world that keeps man, keeps all of us, from exploring that beautiful relationship, the invitation that God gives to each and every one of us? Sometimes we might turn away from God's friendship because we look at ourselves and we see ourselves to be unworthy of God's friendship. Sometimes we might think to ourselves that our sins and the times that we have fallen short of the glory of God keep us from his friendship. But my friends, the beautiful truth of the Easter season is that that is not true. God loves us and wishes to be in relationship with you and me and to develop a close bond of friendship so that we might be friends to others in the world. St. Paul perhaps said it best in Romans 5 when he said that we were restored to God's friendship through the death of his Son. That God so loved us and so sought to be friends with all of mankind that he sent his only begotten Son to reconcile us to himself. Now, I don't know about you, but one of the things that I like to do with my friends is to go out to eat with them. And sometimes I like to make a meal for friends and have them come over, and sometimes we play canasta or we might play dominoes, chicken foot, some game that's fun. There's something very special about sharing a meal that really tends to connect people. It is special, especially when I'm cooking. I suppose it's really special, and that's probably for all the wrong reasons, as I think I have explained in several homilies in the past. But you know, in the ancient world, and certainly in our modern times, friends love to go out and share a meal. It's something beautiful that connects us spiritually and really helps to strengthen those bonds of friendship. You know, when I first arrived at St. Patrick's back in 2015, I was invited to join the RCIA ministry. And what I remember of those early days was just how wonderful it was to be part of that ministry of welcoming new people into the faith, helping others to receive sacraments that maybe they had missed. What I remember is, no matter whose house we went to, there always seemed to be a very special meal. I remember one very special meal in which there was a fruit salad. And I'm not always a big fan of fruit salad, but I thought that it would be rude of me not to have some. And so I took some of the fruit salad. And you know what was in the fruit salad? Garcia cherries. And I was like, this is amazing. I've never had fruit salad like this before. It was delicious. And I would never have had that wonderful experience or shared that wonderful meal had not I been invited by people who sought to help me to develop friendships in our St. Patrick's community. And so I was quite blessed to accept that wonderful friendship. And of course, there were other times with wonderful cakes and things. I would confess there was some nice ice cream. There were wonderful meals we shared with one another. And of course, after those meals, we would gather together as members of the St. Patrick's RCIA team, and we would teach each other, and we would learn from each other. And I felt myself becoming a friend. And so when I saw those same members of our parish family in church the next week, I remembered those wonderful gifts that they had shared with me. Sharing their faith in the love of God, and also helping those maybe to reconnect with him, or introducing them to God, introducing God to people who maybe never knew how much God loved them and how much he wished to be their friends. There was also a fair amount of laughing, as is oftentimes true at any meal with friends. And there was some arguing, but mostly laughing and joy and friendship. It fed my heart, my spirit. And it is, of course, one of the great memories that I still have this day, so many years now it seems removed. There is something special. There is something special in sharing a meal among friends. Now, of course, today we come together to celebrate the Eucharist, perhaps the most special of all meals ever to be had in history. It is here that friends come together, united in the friendship of Jesus Christ, to receive him body and soul here at the altar. It is here that we find ourselves nourished in spirit and in body, that we might go out into the world to be Christ to others, to become, as St. Augustine said, what we receive, to become Christ alive in this world in friendship with all. Now, in the Gospel of John, we hear that Jesus shows us something about his friendship. Jesus' friendship is unconditional, and it is able to bear the storms of all the things that happen in life, the disagreements, whatever it might be, because Jesus wanted so very much to be in relationship with you and with me, so that we would know that God no longer calls us slaves, but friends and adopted sons and daughters of God in heaven. Our scriptures tell us that Jesus showed us the true nature of Christian friendship when he took a towel and tied it around his waist, poured water into a basin, and began to wash the disciples' feet. You see, for God, Friendship is rooted in service. It is rooted in sacrifice. In the last hours of Jesus' life, he chose to show his friends and you and me and all people how to truly love, how to be like him. And so we too, on this special night, wash one another's feet, because God chose to serve and not to be served. My friends, God washes our feet as a sign of his everlasting friendship for you and for me and for all people. He is a true friend, and he asks us to emulate that beautiful love by reaching out to those in need in the world, in friendship and in love. And so, as we come forward this evening to wash the feet of one another, may we do so with our hearts filled with the knowledge of God's love and friendship for each and every one of us. And may this act inspire us to reach out to others in the world, to let them know that here at St. Patrick's, we see them as friends, and God seeks them.
Now place before God our prayers and our petitions.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That priests be strengthened by the Holy Spirit to serve God's people in holiness, love, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations throughout the earth renew their commitment to peace and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who participate in these sacred mysteries will embrace the new commandment and always strive to love one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who seek the Easter sacraments during these holiest of days embrace the cost of discipleship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who nourish at this Eucharistic feast remember the hungry and the homeless. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering among us, those who falter in mind, body, or spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died this past week and for those whom we remember in this liturgy, may they find peace in the loving embrace of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those in our special intentions prayer book and for our own intentions held deep within our hearts that are known to God alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, in your goodness and compassion, hear these our prayers. And as we gather together to celebrate this Eucharist, strengthen us in faith, hope, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we prepare the Eucharistic table, let us sing together from the praise and worship, number 51, Remain in Me, number 51.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become our bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Thank you. let my prayer rise up to you.
Lord, I've called to you, come to help me. Hear my voice when I cry to you. Let my prayer arise before you like incense. Sing up my hands like an evening oblation, like
burning incense, O Lord. Let my prayer rise up to you.
Like burning incense.
My sacrifice and yours and all our prayers be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of our everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, Robert our Bishop, with all the bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in the communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us now pray for one another with the words our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit, let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Peace with you. Peace with you.
Behold the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We now join with our parishioners online as we say the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
As we come to receive the Eucharist, let us sing together number 405, All for Love, number 405.
Joyful hope, and make our way.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the end of the meal, after the Psalms had been sung, Jesus and his disciples left the upper room for the Mount of Olives. There in the garden, Jesus prayed before his passion, "Can you not watch with me 1 hour? We now go in procession to the place of repose, the body of the Lord, where it will remain for our veneration. We invite you to follow the Blessed Sacrament to the chapel, where you are encouraged to spend some time in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament until night prayer at 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Morning prayer will be celebrated tomorrow morning. Tonight we ask that you leave that holy place in silence so as not to disturb others who are in prayer.
Have mercy on me,
mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Amen.
Stay with me, remain here with me. Watch and pray. Watch and pray. Stay with me, remain here with me. Watch and pray.
me, for I am God who is your home. To the desert follow me. Return to me with all your heart. Let go the world and come to me. Rend your heart and not your clothes, for I am kind, my name is mercy. To the desert follow me, for I am God who is your home. To the desert follow. Thirsting for you, O Lord.